Jam? What kind of jam? It's not like any jam I know.
German jam. It's German jam. Well, it's all right. Came from a German ship. Got sunk. This stuff washed ashore. Crate of it. Jam. Our boys found it on the beach by the rifle range.
We don't know anything about it.
Well, it's off ration. We know that.
Well, how do we know they didn't plant it there? They know we are mad on jam. They could poison half the country.
The recent elections in Britain have caused some of us Yanks to look fondly at our peculiar cousins across the pond.
Come away, kid. I don't want you standing too close while he's opening.
John Borman's Hope and Glory is a love letter to the England that he grew up in, Winston Churchill's England, London, during the Blitz. The main character is a young boy named Billy, played by Sebastian Rice Edwards. And the movie is basically an impressionistic chronicle of his experience and a loving portrait of a middle-class family.
Be good.
Bye-bye, Daddy.
Bye, Dawn. Let's take care of Susie.
There's Billy's dad, Clive, a veteran of the First World War who signs up for more service. His adorable little sister. His older sister, Dawn, a teenager who falls in love with a Canadian soldier named Bruce.
Are those some kind of new stockings you're wearing?
They might be.
I mean, no garters. They just kind of disappear up your ass.
His cantankerous and often inappropriate elderly grandfather.
I've seen half the wonders of the world. And I've never laid eyes on a finer sight than the curve of Betty Browning's breast.
And holding it all together, or at least trying to, Billy's mother, played in a splendid performance by Sarah Miles.
Let me through! I want my family!
The movie has an episodic, anecdotal quality, largely because it's drawn from Borman's own memories. And the result is a film that captures the anarchic pleasure of youth. And the sometimes surprisingly beautiful aspects of life in wartime.
Recognize that, Dawn?
It's in these moments that hope and glory really takes flight.
The fins are punctured.
Yeah, it's lost stability.
And it captures the immediacy of what it must have been like to be there as a child as England blew apart and held itself together.